we actually have a habit in our sangha, there will be nobody will sit in the stage. Very rarely we invite somebody else to come and sit in the stage. That also will be in the side chair. And very few functions you will see people sitting with me in the dais. Otherwise, whatever size may be the dais, large 60 by 40, sometimes even the dais will be 100 by 60, there will be only one throne and I'll be sitting. That's all. That's the way our whole sangha works. And this is the only satsang you will see. In the main throne I will not be there. In the side throne only I'll be there. And I want this to be on record, and I wanted forever all the Kailashians should remember, we are indebted to Ramakrishna and Ramakrishna Sampradaya. Nanum en vamsamum Ramakrishnarukkum Ramakrishna Sangathirkkum adimai. Nanum en vamsamum Ramakrishnarukkum Ramakrishna Sangathirkkum adimai. I used to do all the small work. Like sweeping and wiping the temple, cutting vegetables, cleaning the restrooms. And I am very proud about it. I want to put this on record that volunteering, working in Ramakrishna Mission, it's a tradition. All brahmacharis have to do cutting vegetables and cleaning the temple, mopping and washing the bathrooms. This all is a traditional training in Ramakrishna Mission. Everyone has to do, and all that gave me tremendous grounding. I'll very strongly recommend any youth in India, if you are male between 18 to 25, join Ramakrishna Mission. Spend as much as you can, as many years as you can in getting brahmacharya training. If you are female, join Sarada Mission between 18 to 25. Spend as many years as possible as brahmacharini. Whether you succeed and take sannyas or not is secondary. If you take sannyas, great. If not, that training will give you real grounding about life. It will teach you life, I tell you. I have begged in thousands of houses and yates, so I know the best taste. Same way, I have seen thousands of monasteries. I know the best place. Ramakrishna Mission is the best place for anyone to have training.